It's Mario. You feel me? For the bitches. Pink Daddy Mario. Either Mario. Y'all can give me the nickname later. Foreign gang, you know what I mean? For my foreign people. I'm Dominican, Italian. I'm not American. I don't got nothing against American. I love them. I love the bitches, though. I don't love the niggas. Just the bitches. But it's foreign gang. You know what I mean? I'm foreign to you. You're foreign to me. Deep in. We got the little nice, you feel me? I don't even know what year this fucking bottle is, but it's some Hennessy, some good cognac, right? Fuck your bitch up the cognac. This is what we're talking about. Okay. I'm Hispanic, you feel me? I'm Dominican, Italian, like I said before. So I say, let me shout out a way to my country, you know what I mean? ES Mario, pretty much. ES means it's. I'm Spanish, you know what I mean? Some Spanish people, they gonna say it's Mario. Yeah, I still gonna say it's Mario, cause it's just a little catchphrase. Just
right.
It's Mario. Dominican Republic. I was born there, raised in New York, Bronx, New York, on the 200s. I come from a lot of bullshit, you know what I mean? But life told me just always smile. And keep going, because it don't matter how worse you got it, somebody else can have it worse than you. So just be blessed to be here every day and keep pushing. I used to write since I was little in Spanish. My cousin, she can sing, so me and her, we used to make music together. I know how to play the drums. Learning how to play the piano, just know a little bit. I play the guitar. And yeah, that's pretty much it for right now, you know what I mean? I've been making music since I got memory. I always like music. My first song I heard was, what's his song name? It's by Elvis Presley, though. I forgot, what's his name? The one that he was famous by Elvis?
My Blue Sweatshirts?
Yeah, that was the first song I heard on English. After I heard that song, I said, fuck, I'm about to start making music on Spanish and English and just try to combine both of them. Cause that song low-key gave me a Spanish vibe, you know what I mean? So. Right now, I say myself, but in reality, I gotta give it back to Tupac and Kendrick. JC also, you know. Joy Badass, and Nas. Don't forget about fucking Nas. Joy Badass, not gonna beat you. I probably do Chance the Rapper too. Not gonna beat you. Right now, I collab with anybody. I like music. I don't care about the people behind the music. I just love music. So if it's gonna sound good, if it's something with both, you know what I mean? Hey, fuck it. Snoop Dogg. God damn it, Snoop Dogg. Call Snoopy. Tell him to teach me how to roll. I need some motherfucking backwards. I'm running shells and shit. Well, I used to rap about, like, fucking try to be all rap and shit, you know what I mean? Talk about drugs and all of that. But, like, the more I'm involved in music, I learned it to be versatile and be more, able to adapt to other people. In music wise, because not everybody makes the same music, even though a lot of people nowadays sound the same. But you know, you gotta be able to switch flows whenever. So, yeah, that's bro. That's all I gotta say. That's bro. Whatever happened, I'm glad. Proud of the bro. That's bro. I'm be bro, so I can say nothing but supportive. I beat your ass if you talk bad about my nigga. I met Shetty through the compound, and I ain't gonna lie, it was rough back in the days, but Shetty told me a lot of shit. Thanks to Shetty, I get to say my mentality got open. He told me the business side of music and told me how to move in a business world. So I gotta be grateful for that, because Shetty, low-key, he told me a lot without even saying nothing.
What else?
before I answer that question, can I see myself with a lighter? We got a lighter though. That real shit though. Hey, that is it. In 5 years, well, if your music don't work, I'm gonna be trapping, so I'm gonna be rich regardless. I'm sorry I said that aloud. Fez, fuck y'all. But in 5 years, you know, I see myself in my library book, reading books, because I don't read books, because you gotta be smarter than others, you know what I mean? Reading help. Don't read bullshit, though. If you read cartoons, you a bullshitter. But anyways, but yeah, see myself success, see myself feeding my family, building on my business, building on my life career. I'm drunk, but at the same time, I'm not. I'll tell you my age, but then you feel like I'm lying. So we just keep it that way. For the people that told this blood wasn't going to smack, hot bitch. This shit is smacking. We talking about my favorite topic. God damn it, listen. I don't like drinking that much, but if you gonna give me alcohol, it's Hennessy. If you don't bring me a bottle of Hennessy, we not friends. If you bring me light liquor, I really don't fucking like you. I hate fucking light liquor. So if you bring me light liquor, I don't like you. You're not my fucking friend. I'm a translator for you. Si tú no me das romo blanco, te voy a entrar a palo. A mí me gusta mi brugal, negro. Mi alcohol, negro. ¿En qué idioma te lo digo? No sé, pero si no me entiende ahora, me va a entender ahorita, mamá. Sí, ay, oíste. Negro. I really don't know what this, but this looks like sativa. But my favorite weed is Purple Kush. That's always been my favorite weed, and it's the hottest one to fucking get. Why? I don't fucking know. I guess everybody like fucking Purple Kush. But Purple Kush is my favorite. I had mango spreads, had motherfucking pineapple spreads, I had Moonrock fucking enchilada and all that extra goodness bullshit. Moonrock is alright. I had Moonrock and Purple Kush. That was great. I was high as fuck. I ain't gonna bitch. I was stuck for like a couple hours. Me personally, I love Purple Kush OG Platinum. Somebody had it in Canada, I'm going to get one of these days. Also, I don't really smoke this type of shells. I smoke Fanta Leaf and Backwoods. But this is all they had. So, I'm sorry. Don't fucking judge me. It would be Gucci because I like the 80s style Gucci, but New York style, when they had the big jackets and the sweatpants, that shit was fire. That shit was fire. We need to bring that shit to this new generation, the 80s style Gucci's and shit. Y'all doing too much right now. I first started with my nigga Millie. You know, Jerome Millie. We first, you know what I mean, we was there. We was paying for session. Back in the days, I wasn't really into music like that. I was just a writer on the side of my own time, letting everybody get their own stuff done. And that's when we all met Shady. Shady met, he got close to Millie. And since I always was around Millie, I got close to them. And that's how we all came along. Meeting up, we got to meet up. Well, Elliot, we knew Elliot before that. But Elliot also was part of the reason why we met with the Compound, the Bloodhound production. As well as in the road, we met with Q. Trippie Redd and others, you know. Hey, it's been a history road from there on. Alright, well, story about my past would be losing my brother. That's the hardest thing that ever happened to me. You know what I mean, people? I know a lot of rappers nowadays wanna be in the trap life and all of that shit and being selling drugs and all of that and hitting loops. It's fun, not gonna lie. And if that's your only way to get money, I ain't gonna knock your hustle, but sometimes you gotta stop and know that even the people around you that don't wanna do that can get hurt through that. And that's what I had to learn. Me doing dumbass decision got me to lose my brother. And then the way I lost my brother, you know what I mean, is I don't wish it on anybody. It's fucked up. You know, it's real life fucked up. I had to see my brother die on my arm. That's why I got it tatted up. His favorite animal
you know what I mean, with a forest, which means peace. So y'all people know, don't ask me what the fuck my tattoo's about, y'all know now. But life, you know what I mean? Also, me going to juvie, it's not fun. Especially in a foreign country. When you go to jail in a foreign country, that shit is not fun. Bitches is bitches. Let's start like this. Every female that won't go and watch this and feel offended because I say bitches, you a bitch. I'm telling you that right now. You a bitch. You got bitch ass attitude sometimes. And a nigga gotta tell you. So I'm that nigga. You a bitch. Females on Instagram, there is some that is worth it called females. Not gonna lie. The rest of y'all, y'all some ties. Y'all DMs be looking like a fruit punch. Every fruit in that bitch. God damn, y'all got every fruit. What you want? Pineapple? I got three niggas light skin. Like, damn. Real shit. But, hey, I love the hoes. You know what's up. I got one favorite Instagrammer, you know what I mean, out there. My little baby baby. Not gonna tell y'all because y'all so scammers, motherfuckers. So, after being in New York, right? New York got hot, so we moved to Columbus. One went to Columbus, I went to Pickerington. Fucking Pickerington North. I'm from New York, going to a white school. And I wasn't feeling it still, and fuck everybody that went there except for the niggas that I fuck with. You know what I mean? After that, the bitches, though, shout out to the bitches. Y'all know who y'all are. Love all of y'all. You feel me? But, shit, Ohio is, it's just dumb. Like, being in Ohio is like the boring place ever. It's a lot of money out there if you're a trapper, but you just gotta be smart. And that's the one thing Ohio don't have, fucking smart people. 90% of the people from Ohio is dumb as fuck. Real shit. They dumb as fuck. I fuck with the city. I got love for the city. But god damn, y'all do the same shit over and over again. It's like a circle. Get the fuck out of the circle. For real. If I had the drink all right, my drink all right, it would be a 68 fucking Mustang D'Angelo. Google that bitch. That's a car I want. I don't even got to explain it. Well, it only comes from black, but I might spray paint it to red. Because I'm savage. And because of the game.
Okay.
Man, listen, that man right there, he a genius. Elliot, he a genius. That nigga a genius. He can do anything. I ain't gonna bitch you, he can do anything. Like, I don't know what the fuck that nigga can do. That nigga can do a fucking backflip. Like, I'll be trying to figure out, like, what the fuck is wrong with you, nigga? Like, go be a superstar somewhere. Like, you feel me? Even though he is, you know. But damn, like, that's my nigga, though. He pushed me a lot through the music. I gotta thank him, though. Also gotta thank, you know, Millie, you feel me? Them two are main reason why I go hard every day. They push me a lot. The niggas are geniuses when it comes to me. Every day that I listen to my music and then compare it to them, I think, like, my shit trash. But then I push myself to make a better song just to match it. So I guess they too will be my inspiration in a way, but nah, fuck them niggas. Listen to my brothers though, you know I love them today. YV, bro. Not even YB, it's YB, you feel me? Y'all know me and it's YB. YB, you feel me? Like, that's my nigga, you feel me? Funny motherfucker, you feel me? They're always trying to get bitches, you feel me? I be trying to hide my bitches from the nigga, like, the nigga got problems, bro. That's my nigga, though, you feel me? Funny ass nigga, just like me, you feel me? Jiggy niggas. Kill niggas from the battle, you feel me? You know what's up, baby. You know what's up, come highlight us, you feel me? If you don't get me, you gonna get him. Which one you want? Which one you want, bitch? It's a package, you come two for one. It's on the low. That's my manager, but he don't wanna make it seem like that's my nigga. I mean, he helped me a lot, you feel me? Shit, you never know. He might be the one making these smoking mirrors in the back. Shit, psh, millions coming, why be calling? Oh, shit. Hey. Shout out to Huli. That's my bro. You know what's up? He a cuss by another color. He's still my little brother. You know what? Shout out to the Blood Gang, YBs. You feel me? YGS, Blood Mafia. Shout out to all my niggas from the Bronx. And shout out to all my family. Also, shout out to Why Not Us Production. If y'all not watching them, y'all tripping.
Video coming soon, Missy Man. Turn up with me.
What's up? Dang, dang.